Bacteriology of milk. Let's see the types of bacteria present in the milk. First is acid forming bacteria. More commonly, the lactic streptococci are present, which include Streptococcus lactis and Enterococcus faecalis. Also, lactobacilli is present in milk. These bacteria ferment lactose in the milk, producing acids, mainly lactic acid, which is responsible for the formation of smooth gelatinous curd. Next type of bacteria is alkali forming bacteria. The species include alkaligen species and Acromobacter species. Their role is they render the milk alkaline. Third type is the gas forming bacteria, which include most commonly coliform bacilli, and others are Clostridium perfringens and Clostridium butyricum. Acid and gas are produced by these bacteria in the milk. Next group is proteolytic bacteria. These include the spore bearing aerobes like Bacillus subtilis, Bacillus cereus, Proteus vulgaris, Staphylococci and Micrococci. The next type is inert bacteria. They produce no visible changes in the milk, so they are called as inert bacteria. They include some cocci of the udder, members of Acromobacter group and most of the pathogenic organisms present in the milk. And the last type of bacteria are those present in human milk. The breast milk contains Streptococcus epidermidis, Streptococcus mitis and Staphylococcus aureus. So these are the types of bacteria present in the milk. Coming to the milk-borne diseases. The most important milk-borne disease: tuberculosis, brucellosis, streptococcal and staphylococcal infections, salmonellosis and Q fever. So tuberculosis caused by Mycobacterium tuberculae, brucellosis caused by Brucella, streptococcus, staphylococcus infections, salmonellosis caused by Salmonella typhi. The less important milk-borne diseases include cowpox and milkers nodules. These are usually transmitted during milking of cows. Tick-borne encephalitis virus may be transmitted through goat's milk. So, tick-borne encephalitis virus may be transmitted through goat's milk. Some cases of milk-borne infectious hepatitis have been reported. Bacteriological examination of milk. First is viable count method. This is estimated by performing plate counts with serial dilutions of the milk sample. The raw milk always contains bacteria ranging from 500 to several million bacteria per ml. Significance of this test: it gives a rough and direct assessment of the viable bacteria in the milk, and it gives a fair idea of improvement or deterioration in the conditions of the production. Next test is test for coliform bacteria. Method used: inoculating varying dilutions of the milk into McConkie's fluid medium and noting the production of acid and gas after incubation. Significance of this method: the contamination with coliforms comes mainly from the dust, dirty utensils and dairy workers. This test is a useful indicator of fecal contamination and contamination by dust or unclean utensils. The third test is methylene blue reduction test. Method: reduction of methylene blue by the bacteria in milk when incubated at 37 degrees Celsius in complete darkness. The significance of methylene blue reduction test. The rate of reduction is related to the degree of bacterial contamination. Raw milk is considered satisfactory if it fails to reduce the dye in 30 minutes under standard conditions. So the raw milk is considered satisfactory if it fails to reduce the dye in 30 minutes under standard conditions. This dye test is a rough and quick test to determine the quality of the milk. Another test is Ress's urine test, which is similar to the methylene blue reduction test, but the dye used is Ress's urine, which on reduction passes through a series of color changes ranging from blue to pink to colorless. This depends on the degree of contamination. Generally, 10-minute Ress's urine test is done, in which the shade of color is noted after incubation with the milk for 10 minutes. So this is called as 10-minute Ress's urine test. Next is phosphatase test. The method used is, this is a check on whether the milk has been pasteurized. So this is the test for detecting pasteurization of milk. Enzyme phosphatase is normally present in the milk and is inactivated if pasteurization has been performed properly. Significance of this test: residual phosphatase activity indicates the pasteurization has been inadequate. Next test is turbidity test. This is used to check on sterilization of the milk. The milk is boiled or heated to the temperature prescribed for sterilization, and at that time all the heat coagulable proteins are precipitated. Then ammonium sulfate is added to the milk. It is filtered and boiled for 5 minutes and there is no turbidity produced. This is turbidity test. This test is used to differentiate between pasteurized and sterilized milk. Next is the examination for specific pathogens. First is the tubercle bacillus, which is Mycobacterium tuberculosis causing tuberculosis. Here the milk is centrifuged at 3000 rotations per minute for 30 minutes and the sediment produced is inoculated into 2 guinea pigs and the animals are observed for a period of 3 months for TB. So here all are 3000 rotations per minute for 30 minutes and the animals are observed for a period of 3 months for tuberculosis. And the tubercle bacilli may also be isolated in culture. The test for Brucella. It is by isolation by using inoculating cream heavily on the serum dextrose agar or by injecting a centrifuge deposit of the milk sample intramuscularly into guinea pigs. So isolation by inoculating cream heavily on serum dextrose agar or injecting a centrifuge deposit of milk sample intramuscularly into the guinea pigs. And the animals are sacrificed after 6 weeks and their serum is tested for presence of agglutinins and the spleen is inoculated in the culture media. The brucellosis in animals can also be detected by demonstrating antibodies in the milk by the milk ring test or whey agglutination test. So other methods include detection of antibodies in the milk, milk ring test or whey agglutination test. So all the tests adopted for routine examination of the milk should reveal the degree of bacterial contamination and thereby indicate whether the milk is produced and handled in a hygienic manner. So this is about the bacteriology of milk. Thank you.